That's a lovely bracelet.
A souvenir of this expedition. The Inuit.
Ivory? No, reindeer poo.
Ooh!
The most beautiful of all is this.
Wonderful!
That's this. He found the Northeast Passage. You know, the one that links the Atlantic to the Pacific. A first for Russia. But his biggest dream was the North Pole.
Come on, Captain. Let's get to work.
So, where's the North Pole?
On the top of the world. It's very cold there, like a white desert. You have to walk for miles and miles on ice fields, with sleighs and dogs. But it's so beautiful. And what do we do when we reach the pole, my Sashenka?
We plant the flag.
He was obsessed with planting the Russian flag. He adored his country.
He died a hero. You can be proud of him. No! I knew it would be caught!
No, come.
And last but not least, Prince Tomsky, the visit ends with the Orukhin line. The inauguration will be next month.
A very imposing statue, as was the man, by the way. Something of a megalomaniac.
I don't know about that, but he certainly was a man of character, Mr. Councillor. Above all, a great explorer who sacrificed his life for the conquest of the North Pole.
His ship is still missing, isn't it?
Sadly, yes. The hunt for the Davai has been in vain.
The Davai? Oh, yes. An impressive icebreaker that cost the Empire a fortune and was supposed to be unsinkable. So much money wasted for nothing. How unfortunate.
The Tsar's new scientific counselor. The women at court are crazy about him. The Tsar as well. He swears by him.
A real daddy's boy. Who does this Tomsky think he is? If the Davai was worthless, the Tsar wouldn't have offered 1,000,000 rubles to find it.
I'm sorry, it's out of the question. The Academy's most beautiful lifeboat will not be named after Alukhin, despite the decision of my predecessor. And remember, Alukhin insulted my uncle.
We can't do that to Count Chernetsov.
His son-in-law? Nonsense. He dreams of becoming ambassador in Rome. He won't make trouble.
But the Chernetsovs are one of the most influential families in St. Petersburg.
Influential? I don't care. I want to settle this matter immediately. Tell them I'll be attending their daughter's ball tonight.
Good news, my dear. Prince Tomsky will be attending the ball. My nomination for the Embassy of Rome is certain. He wouldn't be coming if I didn't have the Tsar's favour.
Don't forget that this is also your daughter's first ball.
I know. I hope she'll be worthy of her rank. She's been unpredictable lately.
She's still shaken up and coming to terms with Papa's death. I hope this ball will do her good.
You wanted to see me, Papa?
Prince Tomsky is honouring us with his presence tonight. Your opening dance will be with him.
Very well.
A real young lady.
Thank you. Count and Countess Alinovich. And the Duchess Baranovsky.
Last, where were you?
Are these the ones Orukin gave?
Prince Vladimir Tomsky.
Your Highness, it is a great honor to have you here.
Countess, my respects.
And our daughter Sasha. This is her first ball.
Charmed, young lady.
Prince, I am delighted to be opening the ball with you.
A lovely couple, don't you think?
So,
the divine was searched for in the wrong place.
Interesting. But how could I possibly help?
Only you can convince the Tsar to resume the search for the divine.
I'm leaving for Paris tomorrow. I promise to look into it when I return.
You're leaving for how long?
3 months.
3 months? Waltz with Tomsky? How was it? Look what I found. Oh no, not on the night of your ball. Ulrikin didn't go via the Karasi, but via Spitzberger.
Spitz what? I don't get it. Come on, let's dance.
Simple. Imagine this is the ice field. Everyone thinks Ulrikin passed by on the right to get to the North Pole, but he went left.
So?
It means they searched for him in the wrong place.
Don't you think all this can wait till tomorrow?
No. Tomsky would have left for Paris.
I've wasted enough time, Eugene. Let's deal with this and leave.
Are you sure about this? It's his daughter's first ball.
Your Highness, I'm sorry for interrupting, but I need to talk to you about my grandfather.
I told you I was leaving.
I know, Your Highness. In 3 months, it'll be winter. It'll be impossible to reach the pole, and our chances of finding the Divine will be lost.
This young lady thinks her grandfather took a different route to reach the pole. I'm not entirely convinced. What do you think?
Well, yes, indeed I...
You see? Even Lugin agrees with me.
He fears displeasing you.
Young lady, how infamous!
Forgive me, I didn't mean to be.
Nobody has ever spoken to me like this. It's unacceptable. Lugin, we're leaving. This is outrageous. I will not stay in this house a moment longer.
What's wrong, Prince? Leaving already?
I am not used to being insulted by a 15-year-old.
It's not true, Papa. I only said that in 3 months we were...
Quiet! Prince, please stay. Enough. We'll settle this tomorrow, 10 a.m., the palace. You know, Chernitsov, I wonder if the Tsar can still trust a man who is not master in his own home. You see, Lugin? That wasn't so difficult.
Countess, please don't. Please, Countess.
Been punished. Your father wants you to stay in your room.
Please, Mother. I had such hopes for that evening.
Your debutante ball.
Such a pity. Mother, forgive me. I didn't realize.
You are so like your grandfather. Papa used to cause such scandals and never understood why. It may surprise you. But I miss his temper. Tell me it's settled.
No, Tomsky would not listen. No more embassy in Rome and no more Oroukhin library.
But if we found the divide, that could fix things. It would please the Tsar. He promised 1,000,000 rubles to find it.
Quiet! That's enough of this nonsense.
But I know how to find it. Why won't you listen?
Enough! Stop dreaming. You sound like your grandfather in his North Pole. His expedition was a complete disaster. He ruined the Empire and us with it. And you, I had such high hopes for you. And instead you bring disgrace on our family.
careful. Hey, young lady. You should watch your step. I deserve a kiss.
Hey!
Okay, calm down. Without me, you'd have fallen in.
Dis donc, Hatch, tu n'as pas appris à être aimable avec les dames.
Mais je fais
toi et Phil. T'as du boulot à bord. On part ce soir.
That's a strengthened hull.
True enough. Not common around here.
She's beautiful.
Captain Larson, at your service. Can I accompany you somewhere? It's not very safe here.
Maybe you can help me, Captain. I'm looking for a ship to take me to Franz Josef Land.
Franz Josef Land? Why would such a pretty girl want to go all the way up north?
Well, I'm expected.
Maybe we can work something out for a price. 10,000.
But I don't have that much.
Well, there must be someone who can pay for you on arrival.
No. Listen, you see, my grandfather...
All right. 7,000 rubles. You won't find cheaper. And we're the only departure this week.
I'd love to accept, but I really can't afford to pay you that much.
Those are beautiful.
Yes. They mean a lot to me. Do you think?
Sure. They'll cover the cost. I'll come and pick you up there, at the White Bear Inn.
Coulson?
Here.
Briscoe?
Here.
Maloney?
Here.
Catch?
Here.
Larson?
Captain, the first mate is finishing the hull inspection. He shouldn't be much longer.
I'm here.
Frenchie?
Here.
Get in position. We cast off in 15 minutes.
But that's earlier than planned.
Larson, brother or not, you should still be on time.
You could have warned me.
The weather's changing. We have to leave.
But I was doing some important business.
I don't have time for your scheme.
This ship is as much mine as yours. Father gave it
to us. You think that's enough to make you a captain? Learn how to be a first mate. Anything else?
Here we eat and drink, that's all. So what'll it be?
I'm waiting for the captain of the Nord.
I didn't know Lord Petsuchi had the offering.
Isn't he called Larson, the captain of the Nord?
Larson? He's just the first mate. Always one to show off. Where'd he promise to take you?
To Franz Josef Land.
I think you fell hook, line, and sinker.
What's up with that snooty girl? George, it's already left. Lifted anchor 10 minutes ago.
Aren't you forgetting something? I've put your maps in it. Just forget about it. Lund would never have accepted a woman on board.
It doesn't matter anymore.
You'll sort it out tomorrow. Right now, you should eat and sleep.
I have no money. Larson took all I had.
And your parents?
They won't help me.
Look, I can offer you room and board if you want. But you'll have to work.
Have to work?
Yep. At the inn. Housework, dishes. Judging by your hands, it'll be a first. So, shall we go? What about your bag? You don't think I'm gonna carry it, do you? Rise and shine, princess.
But it's still dark.
It's 5 a.m. Well, I've been up for half an hour.
Could you hand me my dress?
I found you this smock. I'll keep your dress just in case you try to run off. Don't sulk. I brought you a nice bacon kasher to get a good start to the day.
Could I have blinis instead?
Well, I suppose you want caviar with that. You have 10 minutes to get ready. Stop whining, it's coming. You look like he's losing patience.
Yes, I've just finished.
Did you do as I said?
Yes. I'm fed up with cooking. Couldn't find my tables. I know how. My governess taught me.
These aren't aristocrats. They've never heard of good manners.
That should make things easier.
That's what you think. Okay, take these drinks to the table at the back.
Thank you.
Waiting for ages.
Yes, coming.
Over here.
I'm coming.
I ordered a beer, not wine.
Really? Are you sure? You don't want to try it? It's very good, you know.
In that case, drink it yourself.
Okay, that's enough for today. To be honest, I didn't think you'd make it.
And have my dress back.
What are you going to do now?
Go back home to St. Petersburg.
To Mum and Dad? Someone steals your earrings and you crawl back home. I expected more from Malukin's granddaughter.
How did you know?
The police are looking for you. They interrogated me earlier. But I said nothing. And I also know you want to find the Davai. You shouldn't have left your maps on the table. I couldn't help taking a peek. You must leave on the Norge. Larsen owes you. You know, Lund is a good sailor. He can take you to the Davai. And 30 days is nothing. With the work I'll be giving you, you won't get bored.
Ashamed to be like this.
Let me introduce you to Lund.
No, you've helped me enough.
He doesn't look so bad.
Maybe, but he's not tender-hearted. Be careful.
Stop it.
Everybody knows the Davai sank. It might as well show.
I can't go down. The Davai is unsinkable.
We spent 3 months looking for that damn ship, so believe me, it's sunk.
You looked in the wrong place.
And now she's going to tell us where to find it.
Yes, precisely.
What makes you think we were looking in the wrong place?
This navigation sheet. This is Ulukin's itinerary.
Where did you find that?
I am Sasha Chernetsov, Ulukin's granddaughter. I found it at my grandpa's. Captain Lund. Olga told me you could help me find the Davai.
She's a brave lass. Listen to her.
So if we follow the navigation chart, Ulukin passed by the extreme north of Novaya Zemlya. But then, instead of heading east as was expected through the Kara Sea, he tried his chances going west through the Barents Sea. He must be there, between Franz Josef Land and Spitsbergen, blocked by the ice.
So, assuming that your report was written by Ulukin, assuming that he thought of another route to get to the pole, a route that crosses the Barents Sea, what proof? To get to the pole, a route that crosses the Barents Sea. What proves that he actually took it?
He didn't have the choice. 2 years ago, in July, the weather on the Kara was disastrous. I checked. Force 10 winds.
A route that crosses the Barents Sea. What proves that he
By the ice.
So, assuming that your report was written by Ulukin, assuming that he thought of another route to get to the pole, a route that crosses the Barents Sea, what proves that he actually took it?
He didn't have the choice. 2 years ago, July, the weather on the Kara was disastrous. I checked. Force 10 winds. No ship could sail there. I assure you, Captain, the Davai has not sunk. It's waiting for you here, with the 1,000,000 rubles promised by the Tsar.
1,000,000 divided by 10. That's almost 100,000 each.
Stop dreaming. It won't be you distributing the cuts.
Winter is coming. We leave tomorrow. You'll only have to wait a few.
But I'm going with you.
Out of the question.
But why? I can help you. I know the region perfectly. Ask me anything. The surface area of the Kara Sea, 340,000 square miles. Spitsbergen's latitude, 78 degrees.
And the captain's age?
38 and a half. I swear I know everything. Mosin, you have a tattoo on your right buttock. You, Frenchie, you're a good cook, but a bad singer. And you, Bristol.
Enough. Don't waste your time. My mind is made up. Don't worry, you'll get your share.
I don't care about the money. Keep it. I must find the Davai to save my family's honor. And I already paid for my trip. Didn't I, Captain Larson?
What? What's all this about?
No. Well, you see, it's just that...
Ulukin gave me those earrings. They were extremely valuable.
Give them back.
I can't. Because I
gambled them away. Tomorrow, 4 a.m. on the pier. You'd better be on time. Everyone on board!
We did it.
He's a man of honor. He had to take you. But you might pay a high price for this.
Board in the mainsail! Board in the jib!
All in the jib!
I told the girls in quarantine, Captain.
Good. Stay there. Maybe you sure we're on course?
Yes, Captain. But there's a storm coming.
Fine.
Guys.
finally made it.
Everyone at your post!
Bad shape. And, we lost all our penicillin.
I don't know how we're going to make it.
We must find the Devi. There's surely medicine on board.
Larson, we need to talk. We won't last a week.
Split the rations.
Already have.
Find a solution and mum the word.
The only solution is to reach the Devi by foot. Look, we found their lifeboat here. They must have left the Devi and headed south. We need to find their route and head north from that spot.
Don't know that for sure. We should wait for another ship to come.
Can't afford to wait.
What now?
We've had it. We're gunners.
Whoa. Calm down. Everyone listen to me. We've saved supplies for a fortnight. We can't expect a whaler to come by here before next year. Whether we stay here or row south, the chances to make it through the winter are slim. We have only one solution, find the Devi.
We've had enough of that damn boat.
Remember, we found a lifeboat. The Devi can't be far. I just reread Ulukin's notes. 2 years ago, if you recall, winter came late. The Davai must be stuck in the ice a little farther north.
That's rubbish. There isn't a ship that can resist the pressure of the ice floe.
It sunk like the Norge.
Of course it sunk.
That's right.
That's the point. The Davai was designed to withstand the ice. Ulaquin designed
it. Shut up! It's all your fault. One more word from you and you'll get one.
Like what? One of these?
Oop!
My brother's right. The Davai is our only hope.
Oh.
I'm fine. You'd better look after them. And protect the girl.
Over there, behind these mountains of ice.
It's a hummock. It goes on for miles. We haven't got the supplies to go round it. We'll have to climb it.
Come on, lads! We can do it!
He has to rest.
Okay. We'll set up camp here.
Certainly not.
What?
We've already lost 3 days. We're almost out of supplies.
Your only hope of finding the Davai
is to leave immediately.
We can't just abandon you here. Only you can bring the Davai home.
Larson is more than capable without me.
You know I don't have your skills.
Enough! You should have already left. That's an order!
You're not fit to give orders.
Is this more convincing?
Leave him here. It's all his fault. A real captain would never have listened to that girl.
I agree. We'll probably all die here because of him. They're right. Get a move on.
Go to Scott.
Okay, lads, pack it.
Work at the White Bear for a month, and I thought.
Sail!
Roll on the mainsail!
Why aren't you at your post?
It's that girl, she's.
Leave her alone!
Lower the mainsail!
Get up, let's go.
What's happening?
We have two injured sailors. We need the cabin. Go with the others. You wanted to be a sailor, didn't you? Anyway, that girl will not only bring us bad luck, but also get in the way.
Who helped you earlier?
We'd have coped without her.
To be a sailor, didn't you?
Anyway, that girl will not only bring us bad luck, but also get in the way.
She didn't help you earlier.
We'd have coped without her.
Are you sure you want to come?
Might not be a pretty sight.
I'd say it's been here a year. It's from the Davai. Then they capsized.
I understand.
But you were right. The Davai did come this way.
Captain, fog is rising.
Ready to get back.
Almost 2 hours.
The hull won't take it. We have to get out of here.
We'll leave when I give the order.
Davai by foot. Look, we found their lifeboat here. They must have left the Davai and headed south. We need to find their route and head north from that spot.
Don't know that for sure. We should wait for another ship to come.
Can't afford to wait.
What now?
We've had it. We're gunners.
Whoa, calm down. Everyone listen to me. We've saved supplies for a fortnight. We can't expect a whaler to come by here before next year. Whether we stay here or row south, the chances to make it through the winter are slim. We have only one solution, find the Davai.
We've heard enough of that damn boat.
Remember, we found the lifeboat. The Davai can't be far. I just reread Ulukin's notes. 2 years ago, if you recall, winter came late. The Davai must be stuck in the ice a little farther north.
That's rubbish. There isn't a ship that can resist the pressure of the ice floe.
It sunk like the Norge.
Of course it sunk.
That's right.
That's the point. The Davai was designed to withstand the ice. Ulukin designed
it. Shut up! It's all your fault. One more word from you and you'll get one.
Like what? One of these?
Oop!
My brother's right. The Davai is our only hope.
Oh.
I'm fine. You'd better look after them. And protect the girl.
Should be over there, behind these mountains of ice.
It's a hummock. It goes on for miles. We haven't got the supplies to go round it. We'll have to climb it.
Come on, lads! We can do it! nothing. Where's the nearby?
Sasha.
We're not stopping here. We're going down. Get going. The blizzard's coming.
I knew it. She doesn't know where we're going.
We're all gonna die here.
Responsible for our deaths. Are you crazy? Give it to me.
No. Stop it.
Give it to me.
Let go.
Give it.
Have you gone mad?
Come on.
Stop it. Don't touch me.
Don't. It's not you, girl. Don't touch my food, okay? Huh? Hey, that's mine.
Stop the ground.
Oh, yeah.